Welcome to the first in a series of screencasts about writing in plain legal English, where I'm going to take you through some of the basic principles of writing clearly and efficiently in legal documents. So here's the basic idea. All writing is about communication. Think about your reader. Any law student or any professional lawyer who simply tries to get down everything they know about a subject without any consideration of the person reading it has already failed in their task. So this is the most important idea I'd want you to come away from these screencasts bearing in mind. So if we're focused on communication, what do we need to be thinking about? Well, it's important to remember that good writing makes the reader's job easy, bad writing makes it hard. If you're trying to impress a client, if you're trying to impress an examiner, why would you make their job harder than it has to be? So the easier you make it for them to read and interpret your document, the better their reaction is going to be, and the more of the content they're going to understand, retain, and use. So in summary, the key points I'm going to be making throughout this series of screencasts are basically these. Your goal is communication. Make your reader's job as easy as you can. A short sentence is easier to read than a long sentence. Plain short words are easier to understand than long words. And remember to signpost. That is, topic sentences and clear headings will allow your reader to follow where you're going. What do I mean by topic sentences? I mean that each paragraph in your writing should begin with a clear sentence that introduces the key idea contained in that paragraph and gives your reader some idea of where they're going. Further, someone who's in a hurry should be able to read simply the first topic sentence of every paragraph in your document and have a clear understanding of your basic argument and the basic point you're making. They might not get all the detail, but they should certainly be able to understand what you're doing at an overview level. Clear headings can help do this as well. You can save a lot of descriptive waffle by having a few clear words underlined or in bold that tell the reader what to expect next. It's very useful in longer documents to number these headings. Now, one thing that students in particular sometimes do is get over-enthusiastic about headings. With all of the suggestions that I give in these screencasts, I present them as principles. They're not rules. They're not to be slavishly followed. But students sometimes will insert far too many headings in a document to the point where it becomes almost all headings. At that point, you've overdone it and created something that's unreadable. If you have a document with a heading for every single paragraph, that's probably going too far. If you've got a heading for every single sentence, or you're using headings to replace having to write in full sentences, you've definitely failed in your job. But used properly, headings can be a real boon to both the writer in terms of organizing their thought and the reader in terms of understanding what the writer's trying to convey. So those are the key principles I would want you to come away from this series of screencasts with. In fact, if this was the only thing you got out of them, I'd be fairly happy. But we are going to go through all of these in much more detail and with worked examples. Now, a lot of these examples are drawn from quite a useful resource. Brian Garner's book, Writing in Plain Legal English. Now, one of the reasons I recommend that amongst many good books on plain legal English is that most of the exercises from his book and a list of the principles that he applies are available on his website. So I strongly encourage you to go and check that out. Now, he writes in very much a writing for business English context, but I believe many of his principles apply as common sense principles of clear writing in any context. He lists about 50 if you go to his website. In these screencasts, we'll be going through about 18. And we'll start going through those guiding principles in the second of these screencasts. So that's an introduction to what I hope to achieve over the course of these presentations. I hope you found this sufficiently interesting that you'll click through and take a look at the second in this series. Thanks for listening, and I hope you tune in again.